Crater Lake National Park is incredible. And it's incredible for a lot of reasons, but one thing's for sure, it wouldn't be this way if it wasn't for all the snow. And the snow is legendary. I mean, we're famous for it. You can see it's October 31st and there's snow on the ground. It's just patchy now because we've had some warm, nice sunny days. But we've had already 29 inches of snowfall since October 1st. And the snow here, you know, it can kind of go one way or the other. If a snowflake has fallen from a cloud and it's going towards Crater Lake, well, of course it could land right on the lake surface and then it would just instantly melt and turn into part of Crater Lake. Or it could land on this side of the ridge or that side of the ridge. If the snowflake lands on this side of the ridge over here, then it's going to end up accumulating with a bunch of other snow, but it'll melt and end up in Crater Lake. But if a snowflake lands on that side of the ridge, it's going to, you know, accumulate with other snowflakes and become a deep snowpack, but eventually it will melt and flow downhill off the mountain, in this case into the Rogue River. If a snowflake were to land off that side of the mountain to the south, it would end up in the Klamath River. If it flowed off the north side of the mountain, it would end up in the Umpqua River. So these snowflakes are really getting the luck of the draw when they end up at Crater Lake National Park. Are they going to end up landing in on the side of the mountain where they take a river to the ocean? Or are they going to land on the side of the mountain where they end up part of that beautiful blue lake? Now, we measure snow in a few different ways because different people care about it for different reasons. And I want to show you those different ways we measure it, and then I want us to think about why it's important to us and how much snow we predict we might get here at Crater Lake this year. All right, let's go. Well, here we are at park headquarters, where we have a giant pole and a piece of wood. And this is how snow has been measured at Crater Lake National Park since 1930. So first, snowfall. We are famous for our snowfall. We get 44 feet of snowfall on average each year. But that doesn't mean there's 44 feet of snow on the ground. It means we get 44 feet of snow that falls. So let me show you what that means. We have this board, like I mentioned, and every morning it's brushed off clean after a measurement is taken. So imagine yesterday morning I brushed it off clean, and then this morning I came out here to check how much snow fell on it. Whatever snow has fallen on this board will be the snow that fell in the last 24 hours. Well, then I gotta get out my pretty low-tech device here. It's a ruler. It's a heavy-duty snow ruler. But I take this ruler and I stick it into the snow that has landed on this board, and I see how deep it is. Let's say it's 10 inches. Okay, cool. Then I pull it out, I write 10 inches down, and I take that broom and I sweep it off so that we can reset it and I can get that 24-hour snowfall total again. But you see, the snow is always melting and compacting and blowing around, and so just how much falls each day isn't the same as how much is on the ground. How much is on the ground is what we call snow depth, and that's what this puppy's for. 21 feet tall, because the snow will get about 20 feet deep here, and you know, right now it's zero. We had 0 inches of snowfall last night. We have 0 inches of snow on the ground. However, we've had 29 inches of snow since October, and if you look out there, you can see some of the snow in these patches. So there's different ways to measure the snow here at the park, and these are just a couple of them. But there is an advantage to measuring snow over a really long period of time. Like I said, snow has been measured here since the 1930s. You can see we have a young friend who depends on the snow over here. If you look up on the weather tower, we have a gray jay, also known as a camp robber. He might be looking for a snack, but I can't feed him because it's against park rules. Now, back to the snow and the math. This is a graph showing average annual snowfall, so what was measured with that board, every decade from 1930 to the 2010 decade. And you can see, on average, we used to get about 15.5 meters, which is a lot, that's like over 50 feet, of snowfall. And now we get about, 9.5 meters on average, which 9.5 meters is only about 30, 32 feet. So you can see that we get less snow now than before. But because we've measured snowfall here every day since 1930s, we have an actual graph that shows less snowfall over time. Will it continue to get lower? We don't know, but we're going to continue to measure it to see how it works out. Another way we measure snow at Crater Lake National Park is with the Rim Weather Station. We're right up at the rim of the caldera, about 7,000 feet in elevation. We get quite a bit more snow up here than down at headquarters. And we have a tower that's about 40 feet tall that has an arm hanging off the side with an infrared sensor. That infrared sensor is able to actually gauge how deep the snow is on the ground based off of how far the sensor goes before it hits the snow surface and returns back to the sensor itself. Although it's very high tech, it actually is not the most accurate way to measure snow because the beam actually can go through the surface of the snow a tad because the surface is actually not one true surface. It's a bunch of snowflakes that have just settled together, so there's airspace in between them. Now this station reads 24 hours thermometer, so it's giving us temperature. It's a hygrometer, so it's giving us relative humidity, and also an anemometer. That's the air speed and direction instrument up on the top of it. Thousands of people depend on the snow at Crater Lake National Park. Maybe even you do. Chances are you live near a river. Most big towns are near rivers, and that's because we need rivers for agriculture, for manufacturing, for drinking, for recreation. We all need fresh water. And that water all flows from uphill. Well, here at Crater Lake, we're at the top of the hill. We're up on a mountainside. And that water starts out as our legendary snowpack. So right here, the snow could be 20 feet deep in April or May. And the water forecasters in the surrounding communities, they don't care how deep it is. They want to know how heavy it is, because they're interested in knowing if they were to melt that snow, how much water would be in it. So what they do is they fill this big balloon on the ground with antifreeze so it stays liquid in the coldest months of winter. And when the snow accumulates on this big balloon, it squishes the balloon down and antifreeze squishes up this tower here. And there's a machine in that tower that can tell how heavy the snow is based on how high the antifreeze goes. And it will then be zapped through this radio tower here to forecasters all over the surrounding area, and they'll be able to know about how much water is right here, plug that into some computer models, and they get an idea how much water is in the whole watershed that will melt out into their river. Pretty cool, huh? Thanks for exploring snow at Crater Lake with me, guys. It's been fun to go around and see the different sites when they're still relatively dry. We'll check in as the winter goes on and see how the snow accumulates here at the different areas throughout the park. And I hope that you guys have a great winter, and hopefully in the late winter or spring you can come on up and play in the snow when it's 20 feet deep and it's just like another world up here. All right, guys, take care. Bye.